Freak out. I hope your break has or is going well. And we're looking at this video sometime after Friday's class and before a week from Tuesday's class. So we need something to do when we get together for our first class after the break. So please watch this and I'll keep it short and sweet. We are just defining some definitions and doing a few basic probability problems. So, here's some definitions. A chance event. Let me get all of it in the screen. A chance event with an uncertain outcome. So, when we have such we have a chance event with uncertain outcome. We call this an experiment. An experiment would be a chance event like rolling a die, a six-sided die, or flipping a coin. So there's an example of a chance event with an uncertain outcome, and that's called an experiment. A possible result is called an outcome. I already used that word in the definition above, but that's what it is, a possible result. So an outcome for flipping a coin would be tails. Another outcome would be heads. So these words make sense. All right, this one is the set of all possible outcomes is a sample space. So, when you're flipping a coin, all possible outcomes are Ted's tails and heads. So, I would write it like this in a bracket, heads, comma, tails. That would be the sample space for the flip of a coin. For the roll of a die, the sample space would be 1, comma, 2, comma, 3, up to 6. There's all the possible outcomes from rolling a six-sided die. Right? And any member or members of the sample space is called an event. So I could say, what's the probability of this event? When I'm rolling a six-sided die, what's the probability of giving an even number? So you can see the even numbers 2, 4, 6 are in the sample space. So any member of the sample space is called an event. All right, so you'll be hearing these words, so I wanted to define them. Let's look at some more examples. So let's see if we can zoom in a little. All right, now that we have the definitions, in this example, I'm throwing a six-sided die. And after I toss it, a possible outcome. So using the definitions we have would be 3 as a possible outcome. Again, the sample space are all the numbers that could come up when you're rolling a die. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So I already said that. And another event could be the numbers greater than 3. So what would be the members, what would be the event describing that? And what members from this sample space would describe this event? It would be 4, 5, and 6. So these are definitely members of this sample space. This is an event, sample space, outcome. The whole thing is an experiment when I toss the die. What about when I pull out a flip of the coin, and I flip the coin twice. So I want the sample space. Again, we're just practicing these terms. Sample space for two tosses of a coin. So what are all, again, the sample space is a set of all possible outcomes. So what would they be? Again, the sample space is often in a brace like this, or in braces. So you could get heads, heads. That's one possible outcome when you toss a coin twice. You could get tails and then heads. You could get heads and then tails, or you could get tails and tails. So there you see the sample space for the toss of two coins. I mean, tossing a coin twice. All right. We will also look at what is the, let's talk about a new definition. Let's do probability. What is the probability of an event? Often that is abbreviated with these symbols, the probability of an event. They have to be careful because sometimes we think of in math, when we see this, we think P times E. So, or in function notation, like f of x, we call it f of x. This is not P times E, it is not P of E. It is the probability of event E. So when we're talking about probability and you see this notation, read it like that. So the probability of event has an equation. Here's how we calculate the probability of an event. It's a fraction. In the numerator is the number of outcomes in the event. So we talked about what an event was. So the number of outcomes in that event is going to be in the numerator, and the number of total outcomes possible is in the denominator. So we would have this fraction, we'll calculate a probability. It can be in a fraction or a decimal. We'll keep ours in fractions most of the time. All right, so in other words, when you roll a die, what is the probability of getting a six? So that's what I mean by this probability of a six, rolling a six, for in a, when I'm talking about a six-sided die. And so, what's the number of outcomes in the event? How many different ways can we roll a six when we have a die? There's only one side that has a six. So, that's the number of outcomes in the event. And what's the number of outcomes possible? Altogether, there are six. So, does it make sense that the probability of rolling a six is one out of six, 1/6? All right, what is the probability when we roll a die of getting even number? Probability of getting even. So it's going to be the number of outcomes in the event. So how many ways can we get an even number when we roll a dice? Well, we could get 2, 4, 6. So that's 3 out of 6. So this answer is for the top problem, this answer is for the bottom. 3/6. We always reduce when possible. So I get 1 out of 2, or 1/2, is the probability of rolling an even number when I roll a six-sided die. One thing I want to point out about probabilities, these are fractions that are always between 0. So I'll say 0 is less than the probability of an event, which is, or could be equal, or less than or equal to 1. So they're in between 0 and 1 inclusive. So when can a probability be 0? Well, let me give you an example. When you're rolling the six-sided die, what's the probability of rolling a 7? Well, you'll never roll a seven. There's no way out of all the possible ways to roll a seven. So the probability is zero. What about a probability of one? Well, an example with your die is what's the probability of rolling a number less than 10? So whenever you roll your die, how many ways could you get a number that's less than 10? Well, every single side of your die, all six sides are less than 10. So the number of ways you a number of outcomes in this event is six, and the number of possible outcomes is six. So the probability of rolling a number less than 10 is one. One means certain, zero means impossible. And all the rest of the probabilities are in between. All right, let's look at rolling a two-sided die. I mean, not two-sided, rolling two dice, they're both six-sided. So two regular dice for rolling, so we want two rolls of a dice, of a die. Or we could say the same thing, roll two dice, either one. So as we do that, we are going to see that there are a lot more possibilities. So let me list all the possibilities for you, and I'd like you to write them down in this chart-like form. So here's my chart, beginning of my chart anyway. So start one, because you can refer to it for some problems as we go through this probability section. So here's the possibilities on one die, here's the possibilities on the other. So we'll say we're rolling two dice. So one and one, if we get one on the other, snake eyes, our total amount on the roll will be two. So if I roll a two on one and a one on the other, I get three. Three and one, four, and so on. So do you see how the chart is mapping the total number, adding each die? So then when I have other possibilities, what about if I roll one on the first die, two on the second? I get three, two, two, four. So you can see this is a chart mapping all the possibilities that from rolling a pair of dice. So when I add three on one dice, one and three, two and three, three and three. So here's all my outcomes. So go ahead and finish the whole chart. And as you can see, there's 36 possible outcomes. So you can pause the video while you finish that and keep it in a spot you can find in your comp book easily there in your notes. All right, so let's see, what is the probability when you roll two dice? What's the probability of getting a seven? All right, so we're going to use our probability formula. How many members are in that event? How many different ways can we get a seven? We can get a seven here, 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 and here. One, two, three, four, five, six different ways that we can get a seven. So, and how many ways are possible altogether when you roll a pair of dice? There are 36 ways, 36 possibilities. So that reduces to 1/6. So 1/6, the probability of rolling a seven is 1/6. What's the probability of rolling a 12? There's only one way you can roll a 12, so you'll get one out of 36. What's the probability of rolling a 3? There are two ways out of 36, or 1/18. What's the probability of rolling 13? There's no possible way. The probability of rolling a 13 is zero. What's the probability of rolling a number less than 8? So we have this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21 ways out of 36. And so you can use this chart to answer many probabilities about rolling dice. All right, well, getting away from coins and dice, let's do a lottery problem, and that's all we'll do. Say that a state is running a lottery. They're often offering millions and millions of dollars to win this lottery because no one has won in a long time. You have to choose six numbers, and they have to be between 1 and 41. So, when the lottery is drawn, six numbers will be drawn, and if yours match, you win the lottery. And they don't have to be in any given certain order, as long as you have all six numbers. So, what's the probability of you drawing the six correct numbers? Well, that's why we had our counting class last before the break. So we were able to figure out how many ways or how many members are in this event. How many ways can we choose six numbers from the numbers 1 to 41? Well, is that a combination or is it a permutation? Well, since I just told you order does not count, it is a combination. There are 41 numbers taking six at a time. So we learned that. And then how many numbers are possible when you calculate? Well, let's calculate this number. So we'll get, and then we'll get the probability. So this is the total possible numbers that you could pick if you chose six out of these numbers. We learned that that is 41 factorial over 6 from 41, which is 35 factorial times 6 factorial. And when we calculate that, it comes up to be, I think it's around 4,496,380. So of all those possibilities, you are choosing one. So your probability of winning the lottery is one. So you're going to pick some set of numbers, and of all the possible ones, yours is one of those possibilities. So your probability of winning is one out of 4,496,380. So my advice is don't play the lottery. Okay. I want you to finish well and have a really good, relaxing time on this break. And when we get back to class, we'll put our pedal to the metal and we will finish up, and the end is in sight. So, till then, carry on.